Hello there, everyone, and today it is another video from the Demon Overlord. I thought I'd throw out another video. This is mostly going to be a refinished product review. So this is after I finished painting my newest product. I did do a video not too long ago of the Reaper Bones barge they recently came out with because I happened to snag one from eBay. Check out that video, guys, if you haven't seen it yet, or some of my older videos if you want to see some cool stuff I've unboxed in the past or reviewed, and some or even some projects. Anyway. These minis here are mostly just for sizing, so don't worry about them. Yes, this is where we actually record our sessions for the Dice and Dummies. So if you guys want to check us out, we are on iTunes. Please give us a review. Give us a, you know, subscribe if you want to be updated on us and keep up to date on our stories if you are. And if you are one of our loyal listeners, thank you very much for tuning in again, because we always love our listeners. So let's get up with the finished product. Today, like I said, it's going to be the finalized barge. And as you can see, I went with a lot of browns, different colorations. I didn't try to go too crazy. This is the finished barge. And as you can see, it is a very big barge. This is basically bigger than even Gargantuan minis. Like, Gargantuan dragons might have to move over for this bad boy. This thing is pretty epic. I like how the boat, actually, I can take that off because it reveals a nice cargo hold. I got painted here, just did some rough iron there. Just for a nice iron hold. We have a nice little secondary hold. And that's for, like, any of the, as you can see, it's got a bunch of bones. I did some green in there for some sloshy water. It's got nice iron there. We got a nice figurehead up here. Creepy and very grungy, which is what I planned, because I always wanted them to be grungy looking. Nice anchor tied to the side here. As you can see, the mast is just a skeletal ram head. Nice stairs, nice bone work. Nice, kind of oldish bones, but not super rotted, because remember, this is the ocean. Things don't rot the same way they do on land. And luckily, it does come with a removable back as well, which I like that, because this could be used as a nice platform for something else. Maybe a special seller's platform. As you can see, very nice, though. Looks very good. Got some skeletons there, some nice bronze shields, some nice metal figureheads. And then I kept the top, as you can see, the gray stitching in the top. The ropes, nice and removable, nice underside, nice use. There is supposed to be a little lever there, but I take that out because I don't want to get stuck on something and causing it to fall over. It is around here. I just don't want to keep it in there so it doesn't snag on something and break, because I would hate to break off one of these pieces and ruin this bad boy, because you don't find these very often. It took a lot to find the one I did on eBay. Okay, if we get that there, refocus camera. There we go. Okay. Sorry about that. But yeah, really awesome boat. As you can see, it looks good. It looks nice and done. I just finished it the other day, so it's ready to roll, ready to do some damage. Now, yes, I know, unlike, it can pretty much rival the ship from D&D, the official D&D WizKids line. I think this thing could rival or take it down, like it's a nice pirate ship. Now, obviously, yes, we don't have a full mast up the top. But you could always pretend the mast is there. It's just, you know, it's out of the way, which is kind of necessary for this type of project to be, since, you know, there's also, I kept the top here movable so you could have the captain or whoever's here being altered. Really awesome, my opinion. I really love this thing. It has actually been a little bit better presence than the D&D ship, because it's not just an ordinary random ship. You could use this for a good ship. Like, it could be a good guy ship where they just happen to use a bone spire as, like, a nice support. And just happen to have a skeletal motif. I mean, it could just be a by chance. Or it could be a deadly pirate boat, since this does, since I do have all the ghosts for it. We could make it like a terrifying ghost ship. I mean, there's nothing worse than being keel hauled by some ghosts. Especially because they wouldn't be hard to kill with their stats and then groups like this on a boat, where they could escape by just floating away. Anyway, guys, that's mostly what I got here. As you can see, it's a good carrying vessel for a party if you want to have your party being carried along. Put these guys up here. My favorite little axe holder there. Yeah, I mean, it could easily hold the four of them up there, plus a whole crew down here. I mean, there is, you could say there's another layer too, or like, you know, you probably could draw that one since it doesn't really have the room for it, but, you know, really nice piece. It's just an awesome piece. I do love this thing. It is probably one of my favorite technical terrain pieces. And I cannot wait to use it on the board. It's going to be an awesome piece. It's going to have such presence. And like I said, guys, check us out on our podcast channel where we are the Dice and Dummies. You can find us on iTunes and other places where you can find podcasts. Leave us a comment. Give us a review. You know, subscribe if you want to stay updated on the videos. We are doing more and more videos. I think we're starting to get close to near our first end of our first campaign, so the end of the first season. So, you know, if you've been following us so far, thank you very much. We love our followers so much. And if you want to get a hold of me personally, you can do so on my channel right here by leaving a comment below or leaving me or giving me a personal message. You know, if you like this video, do like and subscribe down below. And if you want to be updated on those, ring that bell. And if you want to get a hold of me personally, I play Bardis. Also on my account is 01 Berserker. So if you want to get a hold of me there for any questions to me about Bardis or just mini painting in general or something like that, definitely feel free to. Anyway, guys, that's all I got for you today. But stay tuned for another video in the future. Bye-bye, guys, and have a great day and enjoy miniatures.